Morning, Nicholas.
Hello.
Fascinating.
Yes, it is.
Thank you very much.
Yes.
Does playing this kind of music, modern music, due to you, an other kind of concentration than, for example, playing a piece by Bach?
It's a very different concentration because you have to be in a very different condition. Mm-hmm. The Bach is, of course, something very, very hard to focus on. I find playing solo Bach something of the hardest ever. But this is something where you follow up polyphonic voices and chords and where you need a lot of guidance from yourself, or the music is guiding you. And with the Dutilleux, it's very atmospheric and very instinctive music. I mean, like with everything, when you perform, you must have digested this music ages to recreate and not put your own personality too much on it, but let the music flow. Mm-hmm. But this music needs a lot of instinct and intuitiveness, and it needs to come out from somewhere where you have to get your mind to. So you cannot play this with a mind that comes just from outside, and you can just play it like that.
And what about imagination?
There's a lot of imagination in this music because it's a lot of music that is listening to itself or listening to its own echoes. There are lots of pauses and breaks that end with slurs from the note that goes into the pause, and it's music that wants to go inside, and that is what I like very much about that music, because it's not pretentious music that is invented to show how good it has been done. It's something that touches everyone in a certain way.
100 years ago,
yes,
was born.
Yes.
What is there to celebrate, in your opinion?
I think
who are we celebrating?
I think we are celebrating one of the greatest musicians of all time, mm-hmm, and someone who has been, I think, a bit neglected in music history. I think there has been written a lot about the development of music history, how it has been going on after Brahms to Schönberg, to dodecaphonic music, then after the Second World War into serial music. And Dutilleux was someone who took always a lot of time to create art, and he took 3 years to create a string quartet, and he said no to Rostropovich for 5 years. You have to wait with your cello concerto.
Really? Uh-huh.
Big people, big soloists, high commissions. He wanted to focus and create his own music, and he is far away from serial music or little pockets where you put people there doing, they compose this way or this way. He's an artist who touches us as Van Gogh or Baudelaire, and it's someone we have to listen to and who shows us a lot about human being.
The three pieces were dedicated to Paul Sacher.
Mm-hmm.
Who was Paul Sacher?
Paul Sacher was a figure who was very, very important because he was commissioning and he was supporting modern music, and he was also one of the very few people that we don't have nowadays who also conducted and studied those pieces. So we have many pieces like the piece by Bartok for strings,
yes,
and percussion, mm-hmm, that has been conducted by him. And he did so many things.
Stravinsky,
yes. And mm-hmm, the list is very long.
Yes, long, sorry.
And then Rostropovich had the idea for his 70th birthday to say, we celebrate you, and I'll ask 12 composers to write a piece. And Benjamin Britten started to invent the theme Sacher, so he put the letters of his name into notes. And the other composers also wrote pieces for cello for and about Sacher. And so these 12 pieces were performed in 1970, and this is one of those.
Make a link to this Rostropovich and your new CD, because this is the Shostakovich concert and the Weinberg concert.
Yes.
You're very committed to modern music, right?
Well, what means modern music?
I think, yes, okay.
I think these are all classics nowadays.
Yes.
And I mean, the Weinberg Concerto, mm-hmm, is written 1948, the Shostakovich 1959. So this is all
time flies.
That was before I was born. So
yes,
I would
okay.
say. But we could say that Rostropovich, he was very much into contemporary music at his time. We would, mm-hmm, not be here and talking about Dutilleux, Twostrov, neither about those cello concertos if there was if it has not been Rostropovich who commissioned like crazy. He went around the world, and Dutilleux writes in his book, he just grabbed him and said, like, you're going to write a cello concerto, and I want this from you, and I want this from you, and this from Benjamin Britten, and this from Prokofiev. And we have this huge variety of pieces now, and the cello became a much more popular instrument just because of Rostropovich, who was so fanatic about enlarging the cello repertoire. And for me it was important to record the Weinberg concerto because at some point there has been a lot of Weinberg recordings in the recent years. It became very popular, but always people said, oh, this is one of the Russians after Shostakovich who wrote music. It's like maybe second class Shostakovich, or it's maybe someone who was influenced by Shostakovich. It's music like Shostakovich. But when I studied the Weinberg concerto, the first thing I saw on the in the first movement was pa-da-dee-da, pum-pum-pum-pum, the theme of the Shostakovich concerto. Then I checked, so when was it written? 1948. When was Shostakovich written? 1959.
No.
I was like, okay.
Oh, really?
So it's time to turn things around.
Right. Okay. Before you start playing, one personal question. How are you? I mean, I looked at your schedule. It's amazing. You play all over the world. Is this what you wanted?
I always wanted to be very much connected to music. That mm-hmm. was from my childhood on the thing that was feeding me in my existence. There was never anything else I wanted to do than being in touch with art, mm-hmm. and in my case with music. Also physically, I think the fingerboard and touching the cello and traveling with the cello and being connected to it is something that is very soulful or that I really, really need. And then the rest came a bit as it came, and I didn't really plan it, where I and what I was playing. There was always, I always wanted to do this and play this piece and record that and studying this, and what happened afterwards was a very natural thing, but I don't feel it as stressful because it's something that gives me a lot of energy to survive or lots of inspiration to make it through the day, and mm-hmm. I need this this food, this spiritual food, for my life. So I wouldn't say it's a stressful life. It's a very
wonderful
life. Yes.